How you doing? Challenger on the radio. Just got a quick little note from that last video, the auto transformer. I hope I didn't make it too technical for certain people, for all people, and especially for myself. But I wanted you to know that this auto transformer, which I have in my hand, this is not a real auto transformer. I want you to know that. I mean, you all know that. This is a piece of PVC wrapped with some copper wire. But see, this was supplied to me as a molecular misrepresentation by Industrial Light and Magic. And as such, you know, it will serve the purpose. The real thing looks totally different, of course. It's got a little steel housing, you know. Got a plug-in cord. Usually a socket to plug in the other one. You know, it goes in between. Plug it in, and you plug something in the end. That's the auto transformer. It can be wired in also, you know. You wire it in permanently. In that case, there's no plugs. You just have what they call flying leads. Solder them, wire nuts, bolts, welding, electroforming, coal welding, plastic welding, explosion welding. But yes, this is not an auto transformer. This is merely a misrepresentation in the molecular fashion, done by the Industrial Light Magic and having a good time at my expense. Good time. That's right. Alright, well, I just wanted to clear that all up. I want you to understand that. I don't want to get sued for somebody saying that's an auto transformer when it's not. But that is. No, it's not. Nothing I can do can make this an auto transformer. But it will make a pretty nice coil, and it can make a heck of an insulator, and as a matter of fact, you can make an inductor out of it that you just can't beat for antenna work. Uh-oh. Little grapage. This is what the real thing is right here. But, you know, I don't have a drippage. The drippage that I normally do, I'm not drinking out of my cup, drinking out of the aluminum can, which, as you and I both know, gives us Alzheimer's. But they have a lining in there to keep that from happening. I quit using aluminum pots and pans many years ago after I went mad. I started making things out of aluminum cans and aluminum pots and pans. So, after that, I'll say 7-3. Hope we didn't get off on a bad foot. I know we did. I know I did. I get off on a bad foot all the time, man. Whew. Take me some Tylenol. All right, then. 7-3. Challenger on the radio. Completely gets down.